The Khajiit is here. The Khajiit is here. Let's get something done.
What have you done to me? When I hear your voice, it drives me crazy. Ooh, crazy. Thinking about you lately. Boy, you've been on replay in my mind. And I don't mind. Every little thing, all the little things you do. Noticed something different when I met you. Something about you, you makes me want you, you. Couldn't shut it all, show you out if I wanted to. Bouncing off the walls like I need you. Something about you, 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 you. So tell me if you're falling, like I'm falling for you. Butterflies, they hit me every single time. Every single time. And when you're not with me, I keep on imagining you by my side. By my side. 'Cause every little thing, all the little things you do. Noticed something different when I met you. Something about you, you. Makes me want you, you. Couldn't shut it all, show you out if I wanted to. Bouncing off the walls like I need you. Something about you, 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 you. So tell me if you're falling, like I'm falling for you. Catch me for falling. Cause I'm full speed ahead and I just can't slow it.
Khajiit, back here with another build video. Today we are covering the basic healer build. I feel like I get asked about once a month for this. You know, what kind of sets would you recommend? I'm trying to get into healing. What do I need? Okay, so we're just going to cover the sets first. Although I do believe rotation is more important, but you'd probably skip the rotation to get to the sets if I did it that way, so we're just going to jump straight into it, do the sets first. Now the first set we're going to cover is not one I'd recommend too highly, but it is worth mentioning, and that is this one right here, Armor of the Seducer. Now it's a free trait craft set, so it's very easy to craft. Almost anyone can craft this set. You need your magic recovery, your max magic, magic recovery, reduce the cost of your magic abilities by 10%. So again, the reason I recommend this set is because it's so easy to obtain. It's very beginner friendly. Armor of the Seducer. And that will get you a 1-5 piece set straight away. All the other sets are in dungeons. And so it's going to take a bit of farming to get these sets. But if you do manage to get one of these sets, you can come and craft Armor of the Seducer around the set you do get. So whatever 5 pieces of whatever first set you go for you get, then you can craft whatever other pieces of the Armor Seducer you need to fit around that. Alright, anyway, let's get into it. Let's go have a look at these dungeon sets. Alright. What do we got? Crypt of Hearts has Shroud of the Lich in it. This is very similar to the Armor Seducer set, and you can mix the two together for pretty much unlimited magic, which isn't a bad way to go, especially if you're new to healing. Having all that magic recovery means you can just spam Breath of Life forever and be good. So this one we get the magic recovery, max magic, magic recovery. So that's identical to Seducer. So you're doubling up on all that if you combine them together. And then when you cast an ability that costs magic, which is any of your heals, while in combat, your magic recovery is increased by 970 for 20 seconds. That's quite a long time. This can affect once every minute. So, not the Lich isn't talked about very much when it comes to healing sets, especially nowadays that magic recovery usually isn't that much of a problem. But I still feel it's a very powerful set. It's very beginner friendly as well. And yeah, why not? Why not run it on your healer? You have unlimited heals. Very good for starting out in big dungeons. Alright, what do we got next? Alden Hollow has the Light Speaker set, which will add spell damage to your Restoration Staff, which means your Restoration Staff will give off bigger heals. Again, not a set that's talked about very often, but it is an option. If you wanted to go that way, you could go that way. Not the best choice, though. Spindle Clutch. The Prayer Shawl. This is probably the most underrated heal set. I think it's been buffed up recently. But we get our max magic, spell damage, magic recovery. This is from Spindle Clutch. When you overheal yourself or an ally, which is going to happen all the time, you grant them a damage shield of 5,500. This damage shield lasts for 6 seconds, but the effect can occur every 2 seconds. So you could get this up on all 3 of your party members at once, technically, for like 0 seconds. But this is a great set, underestimated. Needs a bit more love. Nothing wrong with this set. Easy to get, Spindle Clutch. Next up, Banished Cells, another easy to farm set. Sanctuary. This is the set I'm currently wearing. I love this set, always have. This is perfect for a healer. We get our max health, which is a bit weird, healing taken, and then max magicka. And increases your healing received by 10% for you and up to 11 group members. So this is good for trials and 4-man groups. We're focusing on the 4-man, this is beginner healers. If you want to get into the trials, we'll cover that at the end of the video, maybe, possibly. But this is a great beginner bitch set. Easy to farm, easy to get, very effective. I'll use it. Next up, Vaults of Madness. We have the Worm. Now, the Worm will give you spell damage, max magic, magic recovery, and grants magic recovery to everyone in your group. So this and Sanctuary are your two staple sets. They are the two most popular sets. A good healer will have to farm and get both of these sets, so that if you do go into a trial and someone's and the other healer is wearing Worm, you can switch to Sanctuary, or other way around, so one healer wears one of each, unless one healer wears both of these sets together. You can do that and have the double orb set up. Vaults of Madness, great dungeon, easy to farm, great set. Moving along, I think that's it. We've got Wayrest Sewers, Combat Fission. I think that Priya Shrew is a bit better than this one. This will give you the max magic, you get double crits, and then when you critically heal the ally, you give them the shield's weaker and doesn't occur as often, so just go with that other one. I feel like we're missing something here. We covered Lich, we covered Worm Cult, we covered Sanctuary. Those are your basic sets. Try and get one of those. Once you have two of those sets, you can then move on to Monster Helms. Where are we? Alden Hollow has Chokethorn. This is my favorite one. This is the one I use. You get the extra magic recovery. Very, very nice on a healer. And then when you heal, you have a 30... See, when you heal, which that's all you're doing that 5 times a second. You have a 33% chance to summon a Strangler that's going to heal one of your allies for 30k health over 6 seconds. It's going to fear every 10 seconds, so that means it's only down for 4 seconds, okay? Because it's up for 6, down for 4, then it can happen again. Chokethorn, very, very OP. I did miss one. The reason I missed it was because it's in a DLC dungeon, but it is White Gold Tower, and it's Spell Power Cure. This is a must-have set for a healer. If you're doing 4-man content, please try and get Spell Power Cure. Even if you're doing 12-man content, I think Spell Power Cure stacks up really nicely now. They've changed it, and it can compete with Olerim's toe-to-toe, not a problem. White Gold Tower is a little bit trickier to get, so I still recommend getting one of the other sets we mentioned first, getting two of those sets together, and then coming in and getting your white gold tower set. You can, of course, buy key frags and go to the vault and try and get pieces out that way. It's up to you, or you can go farm the key frags. Very fun thing to do down in the sewers. Now this set gives you max magic, and then spell damage, and then when you overheal yourself or an ally, which is all the time, you give them major courage for 5 seconds, increasing their weapon and spell damage. Now this set has been frowned upon lately, or taken out of the best in slot category, because it would only go to 4 people, which is perfect for 4 man content anyway. But now, they've taken that out. This will now go to unlimited amount of people, has no cooldown, it's up all the time. I think it makes it the best in slot set again. Even competing with Overeem's, because Overeem's, you got to be in the circle, it has a cooldown, this doesn't anymore. This has been buffed. Get this set. And I think that's it for the basic sets. Going back to Out and Hollow. So, once again, I recommend Chokefawn. That's my number one recommended monster helm. There is Nightflame from Out and Hollow 2, which when you heal yourself or an ally, which is all the time, you got a chance to summon a totem for 6 seconds that heals your allies within 5 meters for 3,000 health every second. So that's, if you're on that one, go for it. I still recommend Chokefawn. Another very popular one is... I'm lost. Where is it? Bless Critical, Troll King. Now, a lot of people love this one. 4% healing done, and when you heal yourself or an ally, if they're still below 50% health, so that's going to be one of your healing dots, okay? If you do a Breath of Life or a big heal on someone and they're still under 50% health, you're doing your job wrong. But if you put down your dots in that and they get hit, and one of your dots is going to tick over on them instantly, this could proc and give them an extra 900 health recovery. Very, very popular set, Troll King. So get your Troll King or your Chokefawn first. And once you got one of those, once you got that monster helm set up, then you can go into your DLC dungeons. Maybe go for Bloodforge is probably the best one out of these ones. When you heal yourself for a group member that is under 50% health. See, Troll King was when you heal them and they're still under. This one is if they're under and you heal them, you conjure a pool of blood. You basically shower them in blood, removes all negative effects and heals them up for 10 seconds. Very, very good set. Very, very cool. I don't think there's too many other DLC monster helms that are worth mentioning. Symphony of Blades is considered best in slot at the moment, I believe. Gives you that 4% healing done. I mean, that's perfect. And when you heal an ally who's under 50% of their biggest resource, you grant them some of that resource. So it helps out with sustain a lot. Yeah, I think that's it as far as monster helms goes. I'm probably mistaken. There's probably some others out there. The only other thing you could really consider or think of, once you've picked out the two sets you want, get the two beginner sets first, and then go for your spell power cure. Get your two sets first, whatever two sets you want to go after, whether it's Sanctuary and Worm, Sanctuary and Lich, Sanctuary and Healing Shore, whatever you want. Get those first, then get your spell power cure and your monster helms, and then you're done. You're set up, you're good to go, you're a basic healer. You can go heal any 4-man content with those sets. If you want to move into trials, ask your trial group. They'll tell you. They'll tell you all day what sets to go get. The biggest one is, of course, we already covered a little bit, the Olerim set from Cloudrest. We already covered it a little bit. This is one of the main sets they'll tell you to go get. I still think Spell Power Cure is better, but if you want to do trials with them, you have to listen to them and do what they say. Bow down, bitch, and get what they say. Okay, I think we're done. We can move on to rotation. Master Weapons is the only thing we can cover real quick. Now you can do these on normal to go in and get you a Master Weapon. Black Rose Prison is probably one of the more popular ones right now. So instead of running a monster helm, you can run two master weapons if you wanted, or you could have a master weapon on your back bar, so you swap to your back bar, pop your buffs on your back bar, put steadfast ward on there, and then swap back to your front bar. Good to go. So yeah, just remember that master weapons is a thing. They're out there, they exist. There's many different ones. Go read through them, pick out which one you like, and just go farm it on normal. Once you have it on normal, you can consider whether or not you want to go farm it on vet. That's it, let's get into the rotation. Alright, so I drag my tank along with me. Go get him. And we're going to put this to practice a little bit, nice and slowly. Got a nice easy boss. Now, tank's going to tank the boss. I'm going to put healing springs under them. Heal them from the ground up. Put mutagen. Heal them from the inside. And then we've got our circle, which will increase our healing done, which is going to power up the healing they're already receiving from those two dots. And we'll also get our breath alive, so you can heal them with every breath you take. And that's it. You'll see as she takes damage, we can be elsewhere, helping somebody else, and those dots we put on the ground will automatically heal there without us having to do anything extra. We can run up, we can put our big circle down. That's gonna heal her. Put that under, now she's got two heals on her. Put our mutagen on, now she's got three heals on her. And if anything spectacular happens, you got your breath for life. That's your basic healer, that's your front bar, that's your restore star. And our back bar, we have our buff up. Protect us. Dead healers don't heal anybody. Got our healing orb and our healing shard. Now the purpose of those two skills is the bubble will give the tank a nice synergy it can pop. And the shards will keep the stamina up to help with all that blocking. The debuff we run on this side is our weakness to elements. And that's it. We have purge in case there's a big poison, you can take that on or off depending on the content you're doing. I like to just leave it on. And that's my rotation, back to the start. Now different groups or different situations will call for you to use different skills. But that's really it. I'm just learning the simple basic routine. You can heal pretty much anything outside of trials. Okay. Ults, Warhorn, general favorite. If you're doing harder content, everyone will love the Warhorn. Generally speaking, I usually use barrier. You can run away if you want.
What have you done to me? When I hear your voice, it drives me crazy. Ooh, crazy. Thinking about you lately. Boy, you've been on replay in my mind. And I don't mind. Every little thing, all the little things you do. Noticed something different when I met you. Something about you, you makes me want you, you. Couldn't shut it all, show you out if I wanted to. Bouncing off the walls like I need you. Something about you, 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 you. So tell me if you're falling, like I'm falling for you. Butterflies that hit me every single time, every single time. And when you're not with me, I keep on imagining you by my side. By my side. It's every little thing, all the little things you do. Notice something different when I met you. Something about you, you. Makes me want you, you. Couldn't shut it off, show you out if I wanted to. Bouncing off the walls like I need you. Something about you, 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 you. So tell me if you're falling, like I'm falling for you. So say it if you do, say it if you do. Go, going. So tell me if you're falling, like I'm falling for you. So say it if you do, say it if you do. Go, going. And I hope you can catch me for falling. Cause I'm full speed ahead and I just can't slow it down. And I want you to say so I can just say.